Welcome everyone. I can call today's SmithFit session as SmithFit Weekly 2.1. And why 2.1 is we have, you know, entered the second year of SmithFit Weekly session. So it's a 53rd session. And like I said last time, proud moment for us. And from art, we are directly jumping to the kitchen this time. So for somebody like, hey Katie, hi. So, Where have you prepared your kitchen table? Are you still at the gym?
I'm at the gym, so I don't have a kitchen table beside me.
Oh, superb! But not a problem. I know you are a brilliant cook, and you also make some mocktails very well. So we will come to that and also talk about some healthy mocktails someday. But before that, we have our nutrition team today, Suvarna and Kaveri. And they always keep telling me that I don't give enough time for them to prepare stuff. And, you give us very less time to, prepare. But today we are doing very simple stuff as they say that it's simple. But I don't know how simple it is going to be. We are going to make some hummus and, also an energy bar. Bar made out of dates. So, I have initially, before we get into what we are going to do or how we are going to do it, Suvarna and Kaveri, I have a question of, why did you choose these two recipes today? And what's so special about these two things?
Suvarna, you want to
actually hummus because it's a protein snack and which can be made additionally healthy by cutting a few slices of vegetables and dipping it into hummus and having it. So it makes a protein plus high fiber snack. So I'm okay. So sorry. I actually answered this question on behalf of you.
No, that's okay.
Hey, Kaveri, you might want to mute one of your devices.
It's actually.
Okay. All right. And you are saying that it's good to have this protein bar before, exercise. I'm going to spotlight Kaustubh and I'm going to ask him whether he has such protein bars, before or after workouts. Katie, how about these protein bars? Yeah.
I love them. And especially if I've got not been able to go back home after my workout, I'll make sure I have a protein bar beforehand so there's enough energy and nutrients in my system for me to recover after the workout.
Absolutely. But I have a question. So have you really analyzed in your own subjective experience that when you actually have a protein bar, maybe as a slightly pre-workout kind of snack, and when you don't have it, does it really make a difference in your workout? It tires you less or what? I mean, I want to hear about the real experience.
So I wouldn't say in the workout. I mean, I've done workouts faster 24 hours. I've done workouts faster 36 hours. I've done workouts eaten right before. So there is a mental aspect to it also that you sort of get used to. But I would say that it helps me recover better for the rest of the day and the next morning if I do have a sort of well-balanced pre-workout snack that I don't feel as tired from it maybe by evening if I work out in the morning.
Okay.
And I'm less sore the next day.
Sure. Interesting. And about the second recipe that we are going to make, which is hummus, right? And what's so special about hummus? The energy bar. So Suvarna, should we do the energy bar first or should we go for the hummus first? What are you going to guide us on?
We can start with energy bars till the time Kaveri will adjust her system.
Sure.
And absolutely. Then we can hummus.
Okay. So I just want to share with all the SmithFitters as well that we are going to do these two things. But please, if you want to have any questions beforehand as well, please go ahead and ask these questions before we enter the cooking phase, or not really cooking, mixing phase, I would call it. So,
excuse me,
any questions?
Anand sir?
One sec.
So, I don't have a question.
Yep.
I don't have a question, but all I would like to say is hummus is kind of a staple at our place. So once a week we make hummus, and for everyone, it's a meal by itself. So hummus tastes amazing with just some carrots, manje, whatever you have, carrot, cucumber, mula, even with Monaco biscuit, it tastes good, though I wouldn't recommend that. But hummus can be had just by itself. Like, we just take a bowl of hummus, a lot of salad, and you just knock it off. And it's a fabulous dinner, light on stomach. For those living with diabetes, check the blood sugars the next day and they will be just perfect.
Amazing. And it coming from Priya is like a superb recommendation for two reasons. No, for two reasons, because, you know, you practice what you preach completely. Absolutely. And, you know, somebody who has experienced this very properly. So thank you so much, Priya, for that. Let's move to Suvarna and hear from her.
So, shall we start?
Yeah, go ahead.
So, first we'll, just give me a second. First we'll check the ingredients.
Yeah. So Suvarna, you know, you are telling us about the energy bar, and as I understand, you know, mainly you have the base material that you will need for the energy bar, right?
So for this particular recipe, I have chosen these many ingredients, but to be very honest, it can be done with simple three ingredients also.
Okay.
So the base for this is a date. Okay. So we can pitted dates here. Second, the source of energy and proteins would be your almonds, or you can take walnuts also. Okay. I've taken sunflower seeds and flax seeds. All right. Okay. Now, flax seed, I have taken for a particular reason, because it is also high in omega-3 fatty acids. So, apart from proteins, we are also adding this particular nutrient to our bar. Okay. Now, if you can see here, I have taken grated coconut. Desiccated coconut is also fine. And this is basically for the taste and the texture.
Right. Okay.
Now, this, we have done a very simple procedure. We have just taken all these ingredients in a grinder and we have simply done it in a coarse way. Okay. Now, this particular recipe can be made into three different varieties broadly.
Okay.
So, one is diabetic friendly. Okay. So, we generally say that we feel that having something, you know, sweet after lunch or maybe in between two meals. So in that case, this is the best option any person who is living with diabetes can have. Okay. Now here, what we can do is, if you are preparing for as a diabetic friendly recipe, we can reduce the quantity of dates and increase the other quantity of other ingredients. Okay. Plus we can.
Suvarna, I have a question. If you reduce the quantity of dates, does it really affect the binding factor of it?
No, it won't.
It doesn't. Okay.
And for diabetic friendly version, we have to add one or two pinches of cinnamon powder. And also, to increase the fiber content, we can add chia seeds.
Okay.
So that will be a diabetic friendly version. If you want to make it for kids, so which is a kid-friendly version, we can add one or two pinches of cocoa powder to it. Okay. So that it is a protein-rich bar plus with a chocolate taste.
Okay.
And you can simply, you know, wrap it in a wrapper, chocolate wrapper, and give it as a nutri bar. Okay. Oh. And the third variety is a protein-rich bar, which we talked about with Kaustubh also. So in that case also, we can increase quantity of all these seeds, plus we can add additional seeds if you want. Okay, like chia seeds or maybe sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, or whichever seeds are available, we can just mix and match.
But what is the idea about the seeds? I mean, you know, dry fruits, I understand. what added value or the nutritional value the seeds bring in?
Yeah, so basically seeds are also high in protein, plus they are also high in essential fatty acids.
Okay.
So these seeds will provide you good amount of fats, which are actually essential for your body, but they are not visible. I mean, the fat is not visible. So that is the reason we call them as invisible fat, but which are essential.
Okay.
Yes.
Sure. Got it.
For this, you have different options. I mean, I have taken almonds. But if you want, you can take walnuts also, you can take pista, you can take cashew nuts. But if you choose cashew nuts, then the fat content goes a little higher. So we generally don't recommend cashew nuts in this. But otherwise, all nuts are pretty fine. Even pine nuts or other nuts, which are not generally available here, can also be added and made more protein rich.
Sure. And so when you basically, make these energy bars, what you do is, you have the dates and you actually put all the ingredients in what proportion. So how do you play with the proportions?
It totally depends on individual. Okay. There is no structured. I mean, there is like 1/4 cup of dates you take, then maybe a little less than that, you take all the nuts and seeds. But what I would recommend is it totally depends on what kind of bar you want to make. Okay. For example, if I want to make a diabetes friendly bar, then I would take, say, about less than 1/4 cup of dates, and I would take more of almonds, like 1/4 cup of almonds, 1/4 cup of other nuts, and 2-3 pinches of cinnamon powder, because it also depends on the taste. If an individual likes more of cinnamon taste, I can add more of it. If a person doesn't like it, then I can reduce the quantity. But it's frankly the trial and error part.
Right. So I see that it's less risky in terms of, even if you go a little wrong with proportions, that's fine. So somebody like me who is cooking, or somebody like me who is not very pro. Okay. So even at a beginner stage, I feel, it'll make me happy seeing that, I could prepare something really well.
And the best part is this can be easily, safely consumed by everybody, and plus it is homemade, so that is an added advantage, because it is not does not contain any sort of preservatives, additives, no corn syrup, nothing of artificial sweeteners.
Right. We we also have Sachi on today's call. Sachi, hey, you are there? All right. By the time Sachi responds, fine. Suvarna, so you just do the mixing part of it, or the grinding part of it, and then you actually make these bars. So just show a couple of bars to us, and how do you prepare?
So
can you
see this?
Yeah.
It's okay. So you just mix it like this. Take it on your palm. The good part is you can either make it a bar, or maybe bites, or a laddu. So if I want to make a laddu kind of a thing, I would just roll it like this.
Right. Okay.
And this is my laddu is done.
Right.
So the important part is the quantity or the size that we make. Okay. For people living with diabetes, I would suggest a very small size of this laddu or bite. And that is the reason we are actually making bites. Okay.
Sure.
But otherwise, we can actually, if you're using for post-workout or pre-workout meal, we can actually use a bar.
Sure.
And for kids-friendly version, we can just make like this with the square version of it, and just add 1 or 2 pinches of cocoa powder.
Right. Hey, I also have another question for, Priya and Ruby. We also have Ruby here. So, hi, Ruby, and hi, Priya. The question is that when it comes to cooking, right, and, when it comes to, say, for example, people like us who are not pro in cooking, right? There are certain things where these simple things are going to help. But what do you think are the typical challenges, and those I would call more of behavioral challenges for people like us? And let me tell you, the first thing is we always give this excuse of we don't have time to do it, right? So, you know, Priya, how will you guide on this? Because I have known that you have been a kitchen master and, you know, you have a lot of mastery. And how do you really start planning or thinking or preparing for cooking?
So, I mean, kitchen master asa nahi hai, but you know what used to happen, because I was working and I was very time bound. Okay, even though I worked in a bank's IT, it was always very time bound. So I had to leave home by 8. And to do that, I had to be organized. Okay, so so a lot of organizational skills came in from that time. So for example, like, you know, always in my freezer, you would have hirvi mirchi, chote cubes ke lele, or naraji cubes ke lele. Sometimes even a lot of tomatoes. So you chop tomatoes and you freeze it. Those are such kind of things I did. Okay, but there are two things. There is a lifestyle change.
Right.
Okay, so when I went through a lifestyle change, say around 5 years back, the entire thought process changed.
Right.
And that was a difficult phase for a few months. After that, you just get used to it. All you need to do is when you're sourcing your ingredients at the beginning of the week or end of the week, you source it in such a way that you remember, okay, these are the things that I have. And that is how. So it is like if you decide that you want to change your lifestyle, that is number one, change. Right. And secondly, go and buy the ingredients yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. As a family, you know, as a family, and then take it up from there. It is just a matter of getting habituated. And we as a family started cooking together. Like my husband has no ABC even today, despite helping in the kitchen or being in the kitchen, but still that whole experience, okay, apan jaun ata saga week sa saga gheun yu, that by itself is a big change.
It is, and I should admit this, saying that, you know, when sometimes we say that, okay, we don't have the time. Yeah. Okay, it's also, it comes down or boils down to the fact that, okay, we are not prioritizing it right now. And this whole starting from actually getting the stuff to your kitchen, assorting it properly, arranging it, is actually and let me tell you that lots of people today who don't have this habit of cooking are, you know, actually getting into cooking as therapy, because it actually, you know, disengages you from just intellectual work and bringing you more towards hands-on stuff. You know, getting things done at a sensory motor level. Because I'm sure that when you're filling up Excel sheets, you are not smelling the kind of food that you smell when you're in the kitchen, right? So the whole stimulation part of it and the whole experience of a kitchen is much, much enriching an experience. You know, so when you are actually doing foodni or you are doing stuff, you know, the whole experience of cooking, and even with, you know, these nuts, you're grinding it, it's actually, you know, it's pretty... it changes colors, it changes shapes, it's so much that happens over there, right? So I feel kitchen is a place which is very happening. Ruby, I would like to ask you as well. Can you hear me, Ruby?
Yes.
So
I can hear you.
So what is the most important thing that you enjoy about cooking? Ruby?
Hello?
Hello? Can hear you. Yes, we can hear you.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, I have a weak connectivity in my house, but still I'll try to
converse. Yeah.
So cooking is lot to do with, within the interest within you, you know, cooking depends a lot upon that, you know. If you have little bit of interest, you know, and have the ability to go and, you know, just experiment in your kitchen, then I'm sure you'll pick up something and you yourself be able to make out something, you know, as Priya said, you know, Shashank doesn't know anything about cooking. But, hello? Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
You know, when I got married, you know, it was just the opposite in my case, you know. I could see Ravi in the kitchen not many times along with me, and he himself is also a very good cook.
Great.
So both of us had so much interest into cooking that, you know, we both used to experiment, you know, a lot of stuff, you know, go through recipe books and all that. And that's how we picked up, you know, a lot of cooking and experience into a lot of cuisines. Meaning I am from UP and I learned so much of Maharashtrian, South Indian, you know, Punjabi stuff, all this. So right. If you have interest, I'm sure you can, you know, go through the recipes and the, as Priya said, if you go and buy things on your own and, you know, you see the ingredients, then you get the knack of how to go about it, you know.
Sure.
That depends a lot upon your cooking. Yeah.
Perfect. So I think the whole point that I was trying to make is it's a family engagement activity if you try to make it. And, you know, it's a uniting and a binding kind of an activity that, you know, corporates talk about teamwork.
Yeah,
you know, what better teamwork can you actually show,
yeah.
You know, if not kitchen.
And then, yes. You know, dare not anybody say, this is not interesting, this is not.
Not at all.
So the family suddenly starts loving what you do. And nowadays with added pressure in schools and all, they ask, what do you do? Yeah. So it becomes a point of discussion that, yes, I made this with my family. So, right. You know, so if you want to bring in a change, call the whole family kind of.
Perfect.
Even
okay, let's come back.
Even sure. Nowadays in school, I see that a lot of children are being taught, you know, cooking without fire. You know, they are taught certain recipes. So, like from school days, children are, you know, gaining interest in kitchen, how to.
Absolutely. And that is pretty encouraging. You know.
So
that is pretty encouraging.
We as children never went in. See, children, they know how to make it. Eggs, you know, all this, I can see a lot of change in children.
Yep.
In this generation.
Superb. Thank you so much, Ruby, and thanks, Priya, for you know, contributing you know, your viewpoints. Suvarna, anything more you would like to share about the energy bar?
Yes, actually, as Priya ma'am, Ruby ma'am rightly said, it all starts with the pre-preparation. Okay, so if you have things in hand, if the things are ready, it takes just 5 minutes to prepare it. Okay, so even if, as Ruby ma'am also rightly said, ki abhi bahut zyada bachcho ko bhi pressure hai, perform in the schools and everything. So these bars literally take 5 to 7 minutes to, we take only 5 minutes to prepare, and these are so nutritious. So even since we have added dates also, it is high in iron. So which also helps in, you know, concentration, improve concentrations. For kids, not only as a protein snack, but as a total overall nutritious bar, they can be easily consumed. And the best part is it is fireless cooking. It comes under fireless cooking. Plus it takes hardly 7 minutes to prepare and also easy to make. Which is very important, because in this scenario, nobody has that much of time to, you know, keep on spending in kitchen.
Sure. Great. Thanks, Suvarna. And now I think let's move to Kaveri. And
are rich in proteins. So when you boil the chickpeas, don't throw the water away, because that will be required while grinding. Correct?
Okay.
So when when hummus is prepared, these chickpeas have got this outer covering, if you see.
Right.
This is removed just to get a fine texture of hummus. But I have not done that because this is a good source of dietary fiber. So why to reduce fiber in diet, right? So this is chickpeas, what we require. Some garlic, lemon juice, salt to taste, And of course, the main ingredient here is tahini sauce. Now, tahini sauce is ideally made from sesame seeds. Now, sesame seeds are rich source of calcium, iron, and magnesium. So they are very good for our health. But what happens is sesame seeds is not always available at home. So the best replacement for sesame seeds is groundnut. So how to prepare it is, you just need to dry roast it, grind it, and while grinding, add olive oil to it. So olive oil is a basic ingredient which goes into the tahini sauce. So same goes for sesame seed sauce also. Similar manner only, you have to prepare both the sauces. So today we are going to add groundnut as a replacement. Again, groundnut and sesame, both are good source of fat. Healthy fats, you know, rich in MUFAs, monounsaturated fatty acid, which is good for your heart health. So these are good for everybody. So it can be used very well in while making the sauce. Okay, now what do we do is, first step is grind this chickpeas. Now while grinding the chickpeas, you have to add all these ingredients. So one bowl of chickpeas and probably 1 tablespoon of the sauce goes into it. 2-3 flakes of garlic. Again, garlic is a good source of allicin, so it helps in reducing elevated blood pressures also, right? And lemon juice. So the basic hummus what you get is like this. This is the basic hummus. So I have sprinkled some paprika powder over it and olive oil. So this is the standard hummus which is available everywhere. Now in this only, I'm going to add little variations. What do you do is, a handful of basil leaves you can add. Now when you add basil leaves, you get the product like this.
Okay.
The rest of the ingredients are same. I've added garlic, lemon juice, and groundnut as a replacement for tahini sauce. So you get it like this. Now when you add beetroot, now beetroot is a good source of iron and folate also. So it's going to add nutrition to your hummus. So when you add beetroot, this is the boiled beetroot, which I've added while grinding the basic hummus preparation. So you get a product like this. I've added a little sesame seeds because it adds more to calcium levels also. That is the reason.
Superb. I didn't think of hummus being so colorful, you know, green and red and...
Yeah, you know, you need to add color to your meal so it becomes more...
Yeah, it's the national flag.
Yeah, yeah. And the third one is, this is made out of dry chili. You know, dry chili, red chilies, you can just roast them or you can soak in water. And then you can grind it with a basic hummus, which I had prepared earlier. You get this slight orangish color.
Fantastic. And, so, Kaveri, one question here.
Yeah, just so one more thing. Hummus is eaten as a snack. So the standard snack is, you know, you can use it as a dip with carrot, with cucumber, and with nachos also. Now I have made a healthy version of nachos with ragi and wheat flour. So it can be eaten as a dip, as a mid-meal snack, basically.
That's fabulous. It looks very, very attractive and... I'm sure. So now that we're talking a little about ragi nachos, you know, maybe a quick wow. That's colorful. So just that we'll not be able to enjoy it from here through the screen, but I'm sure we'll have to take a lot of efforts to actually reach that state of, you know, making this hummus and then. So a little bit of process. So you directly put it in the grinder, all of these things, the chickpeas and.
Do is you boil the chickpeas and then while adding to the grinder, you add all these ingredients, that is garlic, lemon juice. Once you grind it for let's say 2 seconds, and then afterwards you again, you know, add tahini sauce to it and then again grind it till you get a smooth fine texture. And on above, you know, once it is done, you can add olive oil to it and pepper also, as per your liking. You can add ingredients to it.
Absolutely. And Priya says that it's you know, we are just one day away from our Independence Day and it's a Tiranga hummus today. So you know, what better way to celebrate our Independence Day
Yeah, I didn't realize this, but yeah, actually it has become like that only. Yeah.
So the question that I had was that, so when you're making stuff with chili or dry chili, and it gets on a little bit of spicier side, right?
Yeah.
And traditionally we hear about this fact that spicy food will always, you know, disturb your system a little bit, or, you know, it's not great to eat a lot of spice in your food. So what's your take on it, Kaveri?
So that is true what you're saying, because eating a lot of spicy food may lead to acidity, and, you know, in a longer process it may lead to digestive issues also, digestive problems also, like ulcers and all. But in that case, what you can do is, you know, when you are adding chilies to it, just de-seed them and grind it, just the outer covering, so that spiciness goes to a great extent.
All right.
And one more thing I would like to add is, when you're adding this, making this tahini sauce, you actually dry roast sesame seeds as well as groundnut seeds. That's the big reason for this is, although these two things are very rich in calcium, iron, magnesium, manganese, but what happens, natural compounds in them present like oxalates and phytates, you know, they hinder the absorption of these nutrients. So what do we do? Why, when we dry roast them, or when we soak them, their activity goes down to about 50%. So it becomes more healthy, so that, you know, you can, these nutrients are very well absorbed by the body, especially the trace minerals.
Fantastic. Fantastic. And now I'm going to add Suvarna to this mix once again. Yep. And all right. So great. I mean, this guidance was really helpful. In terms of, you know, how to make the hummus and how to make the energy bar. So we started with these snacky items, and, you know, in general, we thought about this fact that, you know, while we are moving ahead with these Friday sessions, why not make them more interactive in terms of actually making things on these days? And we have just started and we are picking it up gradually. So as we move ahead, we are going to invite more and more you know, people like us who are beginners into the kitchen, right? To learn, while there are other places while people learn yoga from us or isometric exercises from us. But the whole idea is that, you know, we are all learning out here, and learning as a process itself makes things very, very, you know, enriched. Ratna Gupta, yeah. Would you like to share something?
I mean, I always have hummus with salad as a dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You've been saying it's a snack, and yes, it's a snack. I mean, that's how it goes. Is it okay to have it as a dinner? Or, I mean, what's your view? I mean,
Because
I'm a regular with having hummus and salad, and that's really, that has worked very well with me. So I thought, let me check with you. Is it okay?
Yeah, of course it is okay. You can have it as a dinner, but I would suggest, you know, hummus is basically more of proteins, right? So if you combine some form of carb, if you're combining, you know, let's say carrots or cucumbers, but along with that, if you combine some healthy carbs like this with ragi, with, you know, something made out of it, so that carb loading is also balanced out. Right, because you need to focus on carbohydrate as well as protein both at the same time, whichever meal you have, not just the proteins or not just the carbs. So you know, you can opt for this also, this option.
Yeah. So along with salad sticks, I do have one or two crackers or something,
okay,
some healthy bite with it. Yeah.
Okay.
To come into
picture. Yeah. Of course, it is fine if it's a healthy
dish. Maybe I have a question also. Can this be had with khakras and, you know, with papads?
Yeah, ma'am, khakras, of course, you can
say with matri also. Matris.
Ma'am, I just heard khakra and papad. Your voice is breaking.
She said matri.
Yeah, and matris, you know.
okay, yeah, I understand that. Ma'am, khakra is a better option because again, if it is diet khakra, good enough. Papad, it has got a lot of salt in it. So I would say if you have, you know, if at all there are BP issues, then papad should be avoided. But matri, again, it is deep fried. It is made out of refined flour. If it is made out of wheat flour, matri, you can opt for opt with that. No problem.
Okay. Yeah, so it can go with all this stuff also.
Yeah, sure, sure, sure.
It will be matri nikal ke rakhna. I am getting hummus to your place today.
Great. And I think that's the beauty of the SmithFit community. we come together to learn all of these things. Fantastic. Kaveri, Suvarna, thank you so much. It was a lot of fun doing these things with you. And I feel we should continue, cooking with our nutrition team, because I feel hands-on will be important. So the next time, you know, let's all be prepared in our kitchens as well. I see that some of you have, prepared all the raw material as well as you will take your time to cook.
Thank you, Priya. Absolutely. Please do send pictures. And by the way, Priya, you can have this during your detox plan also.
Oh yes, that's why I'm very tempted. Can Jaggery won't work, right?
No.
Okay.
It doesn't work with that. And plus, we already have.
Yeah.
Great. So. Kaveri, thank you so much. And
Anand,
yes, Suvarna.
I have list of recipes ready with us for our next sessions.
Fabulous. Yep. Fabulous. So we will also actually prepare them during the sessions.
Yes,
as
yes.
Right now, we just ran through the process of it, but would invite all of the SmithFitters to actually try it out and start from actually buying the stuff. So the ingredients are on your PDF. So the step is, it starts from there, take the PDF, go to the shops, then buy stuff, get them into your kitchen, do the salting bit, get it ready, and then move to the actual process. So
actually, sir, we would like to, have their views also, if they're interested.
Oh, yes.
Showing any particular recipe, if they want us to make any particular healthy recipe version of any food, we would love to do that.
That's fantastic. So that opens it up to all the SmithFitters also to send their suggestions, send their farmaish, and we will all learn those healthy recipes.
Yes, sure.
All right. So here we come to the end of today's session. Thanks a lot.
Anand. And
yes, Priya.
Dr. Gauri Deshpande is my sister. Mami Bahine Ahmadji.
Oh, hello, hello, Gauri ji. Hi.
Are you in the clinic?
No, you're on mute.
You're on mute.
Okay. Yeah. Hi, everyone.
Hey, hi.
I wasn't able to connect because this is actually my clinic time. Today I made sure that there was no appointment at this time. So I was able to join in.
Superb. And so what kind of a doctor are you, Dr. Gauri?
I'm a dental surgeon, Anand.
Dental surgeon. All right. Thank you so much for joining in. And we look forward for, so there are, isometric exercises section, sessions on Tuesday.
I joined in for a small thing last week, I guess.
Great.
But that's actually a big rush hour at my home at that time, 8 to 9.
We understand.
So hopefully next week I will join in with you all.
Sure. And Thursdays are yoga, so you're most welcome for these sessions. Look forward. All right. Have a great Friday ahead. And enjoy your weekend. Thanks a lot. And
thank you, Anand.
See you soon.
Thank you.